Hello friends, welcome to online sessions of Oil Hydraulic and Pneumatic. Myself, Praveen Jinjala from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. In today's session, we will discuss about the reservoir and hydraulic motor. So throughout session, we will discuss about the what is reservoir, function of reservoir, different component of hydraulic reservoir, requirement of reservoir, and then after we will discuss about the what is hydraulic motor, difference between the hydraulic motor and hydraulic pump, and at a last we will discuss about the different types of hydraulic motor and comparison between them. So let's start our session. First of all, we discuss about the reservoir. First of all, what is reservoir? Reservoir generally used for the storage of fluid, or we can also say that it is end component of hydraulic system in which oil fluid will be contained in reservoir. So, first function of reservoir is to use for the storage for hydraulic fluid, and its capacity is higher, and it is depend upon the capacity of hydraulic system or requirement or space availability. Second function of hydraulic reservoir is to provide the filling point of system. During the hydraulic system, there is the many chances of leakage. So, we have to add the many fluid during the process. Third function is provide the chamber in which any volume of fluid can be accommodated. So, it is also used for accommodate of any types of hydraulic fluid. And it is also provide a volume of fluid which is relatively stationary to allow the entertain air to the separate and heavy contaminants to settle down. So, we can also say that the reservoir also used for the contaminant suppression, or also used for the remove the contaminants from the hydraulic fluid, and it will be also allowed the fluid or allowed the contaminants which will be settled down at a base of reservoir. And we can also say that it's also utilized for the dissipation of heat. During the continuously operation of hydraulic system, there will be chances of increase the temperature and pressure during the operations of hydraulic system. So during the changing in pressure, temperature will be also changes. So, reservoir also function as a dissipation of heat, because for maintain the property of hydraulic fluid, we should continuously maintain the design pressure and design temperatures of reservoir. So, we can also maintain the properties of hydraulic fluid. This is also diagram of hydraulic fluid used for the hydraulic system, and this is the diagram. Now we will discuss about the different component of reservoir which is used in hydraulic system. First component is filler cap or breather cap. It is also located at the top of reservoir. This is the diagram of reservoir, and filler cap, it is located at the top of reservoir. What is function of filler cap or breather cap? Due to the continuously operation of hydraulic system, fluid will be passed from reservoir to the system and system to the reservoir. So, we should maintain the pressure in the reservoir, and we should also maintain the proper functioning of the reservoir. So, during the continuously fluid extract from the reservoir to the system and also supply the fluid from system to the reservoir, so we should maintain the pressure throughout the system for proper performance. So, filler cap will be act as a airtight when the closed but may be contain the air vent, or we can also say it is one types of breather or one types of air vent where the air filter is fitted, because during the continuously air inlet and outlet of the reservoir, there will be many chances to the insert in the contaminant. So, we should remove the contaminants by utilization of breather cap, or we can also say it is one types of air filter. Second component is oil level gauge. During the continuously operation, we should maintain the oil level in the reservoir. So, oil level gauge is used for the measure the level of oil in reservoir without having opened the reservoir. So, there will be the one types of glass tube used for reservoir. We can easily measure the level of oil, and we can also directly measure the quantity of oil or how many liter oil is available in the reservoir. Third component is intake fillers. It is mainly used as a screen that is attached to the suction pipe to filter the hydraulic oil. So mainly it is one types of filter. For inlet filler, it is one types of filter. It is used for the remove the contaminants to pass through the system. So it is mainly used for the protection of our system. Or we can also say that it is the one types of inlet filter. In the previous lecture, we also discussed about the what is filter, function of filter, and different location of filter. So this is the strainer or inlet filter. It is used for not a pass a contaminant to the system. And fourth component is baffle plate. Due to the continuously operations of hydraulic system, there will be chances of mixing of two fluid at inlet and outlet, because the remaining fluid in reserve will be normal temperature, but fluid coming out from the system, it will be hotted or at a higher temperature. So we should maintain the these two temperature for inlet and outlet fluid. So we have to provide the baffle plate. This is the baffle plates, which is separate the inlet and outlet fluid. And we can also maintain the different temperature by utilizations of baffle plate. Next component of reservoir is suction and return line. So this is the suction line, which is used for the supply the fluid to the pump, then after the different component. And return line used for the allow the fluid from system to the reservoir. And both fluid are separated by baffle plate. So this is the main function of suction and return line. So in suction line, filter will be attached. It's called strainer or inlet filter, or filter attached at a return line. It's called a return line filter or outlet filter. Next component is strainer, or we can also say it is one types of filters. Strainer is also used at a inlet portion of suction line, so it's called one types of inlet filter. And it is used for the remove the foreign particle or contaminants through system. Next is drain plug. It is allow oil to the drain from the reservoir. Sometimes during the maintenance or due to the remove the contaminants from the reservoir, we should apply the drain plug at a bottom of reservoir, and also use for the empty the fluid. So this was about the reservoir, how it works and function. Now we will discuss about the types of reservoir. There are the mainly two types of reservoir. First one is non-pressure and second one is pressurized filter. First is non-pressure filter, or we can also say that it is general reservoir and it is used at an atmospheric pressure. So we can also say that it is the normal reservoir. Mostly used in as like the industry system, machine tool, because we are not required the very high much accuracy. So it is the normal reservoir and operate at atmospheric pressure, because a portion will be open to the atmosphere, or we have to provide the breather for continuously air supply and air reject from the reservoir. So it is open to atmosphere, so they are prone to be atmosphere, and many chances of contaminants will be added during the process. So it is generally not used for the heavy capacity of hydraulic system. Second one is pressurized. Means we have to maintain the pressure of reservoir up to the 0.35 to the 1.5 bar. And pressure is maintained by utilizations of small capacity of compressor. So we said should maintain the pressure above the atmospheric pressure. So it's called pressurized reservoir. Advantages of pressurized reservoir is to we can easily supply the fluid to pump, or we can also say that it will be improve the efficiency or performance of hydraulic pump. So it is avoids a boost pressure to the main pump and prevent the ignite of the dirt, because we can also say that due to the higher pressure inside the reservoir, it will be remove or prevent the dust particle to add it into reservoir. But we have to also maintain pressure, so we have to also maintain the supply the extra energy source. It's like the compressor for supply the pressurized air. So this is the mainly difference between the non-pressurized and pressurized reservoir. Non-pressurized reservoir generally operate at atmospheric pressure, and pressurized reservoir operate at above the atmospheric pressure. Non-pressurized, it is simple type. There is the no maintenance, or we can also say the minimum maintenance. While during the pressurized reservoir, we should maintain the pressure by applying the compressor or different equipment. So we have to maintain the time to time. Non-pressurized reservoir generally used at a normal system, but while at a heavy capacity, or we can also say that for improve the performance of hydraulic system, we should maintain the pressure inside the reservoir. So we should prefer the pressurized reservoir. And pressurized reservoir also improve the performance of pump and also prevent the dust particle added from atmosphere. So this is the comparison between the non-pressurized and pressurized reservoir. Now we will discuss about the hydraulic motor. What is hydraulic motor, how it works, and comparison with hydraulic pump. First of all, we discuss about the function of hydraulic motor. Hydraulic motor is mainly used for conversions of mechanical energy or hydraulic energy into the rotary motion. So the main function of pump is to convert mechanical into hydraulic, while the hydraulic motor is used for conversions of hydraulic energy into rotary motion. So we can also say that it is convert the hydraulic pressure or flow into the torque or angular displacement, or we can also say that in rotational motion. So hydraulic motor is nothing but conversions of pressurized energy into the rotary motion, while the electrical motor used for conversions of electrical energy into the rotary motion. So same is like the function, hydraulic motor used for conversions of pressurized energy or high pressurized energy or hydraulic energy into the rotary motion. Now we will discuss about the difference between the pump and motor. Hydraulic motor generally used for conversions of hydraulic energy into mechanical energy in form of rotary motion, while the hydraulic pump used for conversions of mechanical energy into the hydraulic energy. So we can also say that the construction of pump and hydraulic motor are almost similar but opposite to the function. Pump mainly used for the supply the pressurized energy to the hydraulic system, while the motor used for the conversions of that pressurized energy into the mechanical energy in form of rotary motion. There are the many types of hydraulic motor according to the construction, according to requirement, according to output. Here the type general use for hydraulic motor is like the gear motor, vane motor and piston motor. Almost the construction of the hydraulic motor and hydraulic pump is same, but difference between output. In pump we are supplying the mechanical energy and we are getting the hydraulic energy, while in hydraulic motor we are supplying the pressurized energy or hydraulic energy and we are getting the mechanical energy in form of rotary motion. Now we will discuss about step by step different types of hydraulic motor. First hydraulic motor is gear motor, means two opposite gears are rotating in opposite direction whenever we supply the pressurized fluid. So we can also say that it is opposite function to the gear pump. In gear pump, we have to rotate the gear by utilization of electrical motor and we get the outlet pressurized energy. While in hydraulic motor, in which gear motor, we have to supply the pressurized hydraulic fluid to the two matching gears. So what's happened? Whenever we supply the pressurized hydraulic fluid to the gear, so gear will be start to the rotate and we get at outlet hydraulic fluid. So which convert hydraulic energy into mechanical energy, and both gear will be rotated in opposite direction. This is the symbols of hydraulic motor, and this is the bi-directional constant displacement type hydraulic motor. This is also schematic diagram. There are the two gear rotated in opposite direction. If you supply the pressurized fluid, so gear will be rotated, so we get the rotary motion. Second one is G rotor motor. It is also same as like the G rotor hydraulic pump. Construction is same but opposite in function. In G rotor, there is the main difference between the external and internal gear is number of tooth 1. So there is the 1 tooth difference between the external and internal gear. Whenever we supply the pressurized hydraulic fluid to the G rotor motor, so it will be start to the rotating and fluid will be goes to the outlet. So we can also say that it will use for conversions of hydraulic energy into the mechanical energy. And at a shaft, we get the rotary motion. Third hydraulic motor is vane type motor, similar as like one shaft is mounted with rotor and rotor is mounted with the vane. Whenever we supply pressurized fluid at an inlet, so vane will be start to the rotate and it will be transmit the energy to the rotor and rotor will be transmit the energy to the shaft and shaft will be start to the rotation and at an end fluid will be pass out. So mainly three process. First process, it will be transfer the fluid, or we can also say the fill up the fluid, transfer fluid, and it will be goes to the exhaust. So whenever we supply the pressurized fluid to the inlet, so vane will be start to the rotation and we get the rotary motion. So it's called hydraulic motor. And this is the practical diagram, or practically in market it is available of these types of hydraulic motor. Whenever you supply the pressurized fluid, so vane will be start to the rotate. So also start the rotation of rotor and shaft and we get the rotational motion. Now we will discuss about the piston motor. There are the two types of piston motor, inline and bent axis type piston motor. First one is inline axis type piston motor. Whenever we supply the pressurized energy to the swiss plate type hydraulic pump, so what's happen? It will be start to rotation. So we can also say that it is the opposite function to the hydraulic motor. Here the pressurized fluid will be supplied to the different arrangement of piston and barrel. So what's happen? Due to the inclination of this plate, whenever we supply the pressurized fluid, so it will be apply the pressure to the piston and piston will be start to the rotation and we get the rotary motion. At upper piston, it will be discharge. So we get outlet of fluid. So same as like the swiss plate type hydraulic pump. In swiss type plate type hydraulic pump, we get the pressurized fluid. While we supply the pressurized fluid to similar arrangement, so we can get the rotary motion. So same is like the swiss plate, or we can also say the it is the inclined plate, and angle we can also set by external pilot operation. So we can also set the this inclination and we can also get the different torque and different RPM according to the requirement. Second piston type is piston motor as like the bent axis. In difference between the inline axis and bent axis is, in bent axis the rotating barrel and axis of the shaft, there will be at a angle. So it's called bent axis. Here the no requirement of inclined plate because they are already supply the angle. So we can get the easily rotary motion. Whenever we supply the pressurized energy to the piston and piston will be apply the force to the bent axis barrel and we get the rotary motion. So same is like the construction is like the bent axis piston pump, but only for in opposite function. So this was the about the piston motor as like the inline axis and bent axis type the piston. Now we will discuss about the radial piston motor. Means two or more than two cylinder used for rotation of only one shaft. So it's called radial motor. Means piston cylinder arrangement will be arranged in radial direction. Whenever we supply the pressurized fluid to the piston, so it will be transmit the power to the one shaft. And different radial positions of different piston, we got the one shaft rotation. So we can also get the higher torque compared to the other hydraulic motor. For so piston radial motor used for generally at a higher capacity, or we can also say it is used for the higher torque requirement, in which all piston will be arranged in radial direction and supply the pressurized fluid to the at a different time at a different piston cylinder arrangement. So we will get the rotary motion, or it is also we can say that it is the construction near to the radial engine or similar to the radial engine. And this is the diagram of practically available in market. Whenever we supply the pressurized fluid at a different piston at a different location. So shaft will be start to the rotation and we got the higher torque. So this was the about the hydraulic motor.